You know, after you've saved up enough money to actually have the down payment ready to go on a farm, what I would suggest a buyer do next is actually reach out to a Whitetail Properties land specialist and get connected with them in the area that you want to buy, to set your expectations in a reasonable level as to what you're looking for, the number of acres, the size of property, your timber mix. And not only can y'all start to have that conversation about land, but they're also going to get you hooked up with a number of different lenders that you can actually talk to and get a good idea and go ahead and get pre-approved for a certain lending limit. And what that's going to do is whenever you have an offer, whenever you find that perfect property, you're going to be able to know whether you can afford it and actually put that offer together really quickly. I showed a property just last week to a buyer who hadn't talked to a lender yet. He saw a farm. He called me about it and he wanted to see it. We went out and we looked at it. And after looking at it, he's like, man, I really want the farm, but I don't have enough money for the down payment. And I might be able to swing it, but I might not, you know? And so that's not where the conversation stopped. But I said, man, let's get your financial information together. Let's get it to a lender, you know, and let's see where you're at, you know? I mean, because until you have that, you're not going to be able to put an offer together in a timely manner. And you're not going to be able to actually execute whenever you find the perfect farm. So whenever you find that farm, you want to be ready to go. And talking to a Whitetail Properties land specialist, having them get you hooked up with some land lenders, it's just a phenomenal way to start that process and to have a great experience when looking for the perfect farm. You know, when you start talking about the affordability of land in the South, you really get into timber values. And then the Piney Hills versus the bottomlands. And there's a lot of different mix and property types. And there's just a lot of different values out there. Even county by county, parish by parish in Louisiana, it can vary significantly based on your distance from a city or whatnot. So if you're in town and you're talking to people about land values, yeah, I mean, if you're talking about going 2 miles outside of town, yeah, it's a significantly different price than, you know, if you get out in the country some, you know. So, but I mean, when you talk about the Piney Hills where you can grow good pine timber, you know, in pine plantations and it's got standing timber on it that's 30 years old and that's saw timber and it's ready to cut, just the timber value on that property may be 2 to 3 times the dirt value. You know, but when you start talking about the actual dirt value, I mean, you can go out there and maybe buy a cutover or a replanted pine plantation, and you can buy it at half price what you can buy a mature pine stand for. And then, you know, as that property, you know, that timber grows and appreciates, you're getting that appreciation. And man, I tell you, the hybrids they have now in these pine plantations are just unreal when you get the amount of volume and when you can harvest it and the first thinning and the second thinning. So, and then when you start looking at the bottom ground timber, I mean, and you start talking about bottom ground oak timber that's got mature trees on it, man, the timber value is just, it's right now, it's skyrocketed, you know. But even in the timber market, you know, it comes up and down, it ebbs and flows. So, you know, I mean, you can buy some that's been thin, or you can buy a hardwood bottom that's been clear cut even, you know, and you can find some great values out there that are way below what the average land price might be. So in the South, you just really have to evaluate it based on your land type as far as bottomlands or upland pine, what kind of timber it can grow, and then also the standard timber it has on it. So, but you just think, man, a clear cut without any timber is worth a significant amount less, you know, than if it had saw logs on it. So I just go out there and I talk to a Whitetail Properties land specialist and just kind of get a better understanding about what the prices are and where, you know, I mean, you may be able to go, you know, an hour this direction and it's 2 to 3 times property in an hour in this direction, you know. I think for just about everybody out there, you can find what you're looking for. You know, if you're a first-time land buyer or you don't own any land, you may not have thought about the actual income that the property can produce and how the property can actually help you pay for itself. You know, I've bought farms and within a year or two, I've been able to thin the timber on it, you know, and either first or second thinning, and be able to use that money to just, I mean, pay the note down and just reduce my payments. Another thing that I've done is I've purchased farms and actually for hunting that I want to hunt, but I can't afford to at the time. And so I want to hunt it in 5 or 10 years down the road. And I've actually leased the farm out for hunting rights, you know, and actually use that farming income to help pay for the farm. I mean, I can still remember one of the conversations I had with my wife whenever I told her where I wanted to buy the farm, because it was about 5 miles from the house. And that I wanted to hunt it, you know, because it was so close to home. And then in a subsequent conversation, I told her that I was going to lease the hunting out. And she looked at me like I had a third head, you know. I mean, it's there's just a lot of different opportunities in property. I mean, there's the CRP payments that you could enroll it in a government program. I mean, a WRE program that you could enroll it in. There's just a lot of opportunities out there. I mean, where you can put in conservation easements. I mean, right now there's a lot of carbon credit opportunities out there where you can actually, even on mature stands of timber, you can actually sell carbon credits. You know, it used to be that, you know, there was a specific group of timber that you could only do that on where it had been planted since about 2000. But now, I mean, they're even selling carbon credits on established hardwood forest, you know, or even pine timber plantations. So it's there's just a lot of opportunities out there to make land more affordable for you. CRP is a great program. It provides annual income to the landowner for basically converting their once tillable farms or once in agricultural type production into a more wildlife beneficial habitat. And they'll come in, they'll do plantings, they'll do some design work. What's really cool about CRP too that I'm just learning is that you're actually able to convert your CRP acres into a WRE, which used to be called WRP. A WRE program if you'd like to. And that's just a tremendous benefit for somebody if you don't want to receive that annual income, but you'd like to save a one-time payment. It's actually a great way to convert the property. The government will actually come in and do different improvements on your property and to convert that. So, I mean, it's another great opportunity to and something that's a niche in the CRP programs.